hey, I just noticed that gold put us down below 152. Less than 2 more minutes to go before I'm really, really excited about my sum of best. Am I ready for bad games tomorrow? There's no way I can be. I'm really looking forward to it, though. Not what I wanted to do. I would love a heart drop right here. Yeah, there's a lot of randomizers. But not too bad. Probably like minus 5, I'm gonna guess. Minus 8. What game doesn't have a randomizer at this point? Mostly modern games, really. We're there's a really, really good community just around disassembling and documenting games. And that's led to lots of really, really good info for people who want to implement randomizers. A little bit upset at being knocked to the left there. I feel like that's not how that should have happened, but whatever. Wasn't too bad. .03 off of gold, even with a second try, zip. That's not too bad. Stream. I hope that you enjoy your look. Thank you very much for the good look. So far, this one's going pretty okay. Not gonna get my hopes up, but so far, I'm real happy with what's happening. Slow, but not too bad. minor time loss, but I didn't screw up the bat manipulation, so... Alright, well that's gonna lose a little bit of time. That's a bummer. I should have known that I did that just a little bit too late. I think we're still green, but not by a ton now. Yeah, we're like a million years off of gold, but... Oh! We're still on a pretty solid pace. So I'm just gonna lounge for a moment to scrub off a bit more time. Because you never want to PB by too much. You want to see a poison cloud here. Nice. That gives us iframes to run through everything. Not the worst, not great. Oh. So I'm one... Do I know if it's possible to load a specific game splits in live split from the command line? I do not know. Sure is resetting here. Yeah, I'm gonna be real with you. Well, one or more parts of this speedrun so far that have not been fast. Cycle, which is the worst thing ever, but would have been okay with not losing it. thanks for the good luck. So far we're on pace, so let's see what happens. Just kidding. Too far to the left. That could have been real bad. Optimal fight. Tied with gold. Not too bad. Not too shabby, especially when you consider that, that I had that, that really bad one screen. Yeah, thank you for the congrats. Yeah, I'm real happy with the sub too, but gotta push it harder. At this point, I'm not gonna be happy until sub 150, honestly. I don't know where I'm gonna find some of the time for sub 150, but... gotta happen. Yeah, these runs are super fun. They're real comfy. I think there's a bunch of new tech that you're not going to recognize, which will be pretty fun. Please? There we go. Gotta kill the frog. This is not good. Yo, Amatrine Kithera, thank you so, so much for 2 months in a row. That is the most cursed resub message that I've ever received. Thank you. I hate it. Just in case this is the world record, please? Just in case this is the world record and this gets cut into a VOD, I'm gonna read that resub message. And it's going to be attributed specifically to Twitch user Amatrine Kithera. So I hope you're real proud of what you've done, because it's cursed. Does the frog find anything that he eats to be scrumdiddlyumptious? So for anybody who's not aware of the YouTube channel Scrumdiddlyumptious, it is food crumbs. If you were wondering, you know, I really want to commit some crimes, but I'd prefer that food be involved somehow. I've got the YouTube channel for you. I know what I did. I'm glad you know what you did. So today I took lunch, and I said, my good friend Doc is streaming. It was my lunch break to watch Doc stream. You know, watch one of my favorite comfy daytime streams, and eat some food. It turns out that Doc was also having lunch at the time, and apparently part of Doc's lunchtime routine is to watch Scrumdiddlyumptious on YouTube. Real good. Wait, no. What's the other thing? Bad. It's real bad. Also, anybody who isn't already following Doc, M_D_C_T, which is a much worse name to say than just Doc, you should be following, because Doc has such a good stream. Creations come from, and then you get the close enough meme on Reddit. No. Nope. Scrumdiddlyumptious is just straight up food crimes. they have this habit of, like, doing something that seems really, really good, and then, like, oh, by the way, we're also gonna deep fry it. It looked great, but now it's deep fried, and it looks terrible. I understand that you think that, but I am here to tell you that, in fact, not all foods are better deep fried. Oh yeah, you're not gonna be learning how to make health food. Minimal hassle, at least. Thank you. A couple seconds slower than it necessarily had to be, but got there. Oh, that was pure skill. Sure, that's not how you're supposed to do that either. Thank you very much for the host. Welcome, everyone. Thank you very much for the good luck. There's rocks rubber banded. Yes, sort of. There's a couple of spots where the rock will catch up to you no matter what. And then there's a couple of spots where you do have to wait. They ate my jump. I almost got to hover all the way back up. That would have been great. Would have loved it. How's it going, Treble Gaming? Yeah, jumps are super tasty. Just gonna go ahead and thread the needle there. Also, that floor stops existing when you open the door, which is real neat. Nope, nope, there we go. That's what you want. Yeah, the Mode 7 boss. That's a good way of thinking of him. Look, this is a Nintendo console. We've got Mode 7 now. Mode 7 is the best mode. Okay. That's fine. You do you. That's why PC has been delayed. It's because they're trying to figure out how to implement Mode 7 on modern graphics hardware. It's just not... it's not up to the task. Yeah, they're planning on a PC port. Given what recent updates have done to the game, I'm going to go out on a limb here and I'm going to say for speedrunning, PC is probably not going to be the way to go. That for most runners, there we go. For most runners, it's going to be the PS4 physical release that's going to be the best for running. For this, it's frame perfect. Nope. Only frame perfect trick in the game. Yeah, I have this kind of bad feeling that the PC port is going to fix, like, all of the really useful glitches, since the most recent console release has fixed all of the useful glitches. It's a bummer. It means that people who want to speedrun this game need to buy the physical version, which... ironically, from a logistics standpoint, probably means that the publisher is making less money per unit. Yeah, specifically fixing useful glitches that will never ever come up in casual playthroughs. Like, there's one glitch that that boulder skip that I did just a moment ago that I think is understandable that they fixed, because, you know, that can happen casually. I know, because we accidentally discovered that glitch casually. That glitch was known before, like, there was even my speedrun route. But now there's a bunch of glitches, like flying disco pigs been fixed in 104, which is a bummer. Or, potentially, like, the other thing that they could do is continue fixing the glitches, and maybe they'll give us a backported patch of 100. Then PC would be the best way to go. This one. Thank you. I'm gonna have to wait. Still on pace for a 154. Halfway through the run, not bad. So, I was really careful to make sure that I took some damage. It's not where you want to use that fireball. Anyway, I was really careful to make sure that I took some damage, because I want to use the inn up in area, I think it's called. Okay. in addition to, in addition to refilling my health, using the inn is also going to refill my stamina, which is really important for an upcoming run section. Way, way faster than standing still for a long time. Sets us up for fast cycles for all of this area, which is real nice. Setting up for another glitch here. There we go. Second try is pretty good. Yeah, we finally found a use for that glitch, which is really great. One thing that's really funny is that the PlayStation 4 version of the run uses the same glitch, sort of, but in a totally different way, because the way that they have damage input for that rod is totally different. So good. Yeah, I'm feeling pretty comfortable with movement in this round at this point. Say, and then immediately mess up the movement. Switch out lava bubble then. It's just staying in place. World record gets his first try. There we go. Anyway, this is a Sonic room. At the very end of the room, we're gonna see Sonic. There he is. We lost like 20 seconds there. That's a bummer. Thank you very much for the good luck. Hi, Peppy. Bye, Peppy. Rocket launcher, thank you very much for the good luck. Don't worry, I'm sure Peppy's fine. Cloudy Shoe, thank you for the good luck. Sintera, it's going pretty okay. We're gonna see really how okay it's going after I beat the next boss and see how much time I lost in this. So far, this has been okay. Stupid hover's coming up, so let's just try that one again, shall we? This is gonna be a red split. That's a bummer. Start the stupid hover, why don't I jump beforehand? Okay, so the reason for that is because I need both of my double jumps. I need both of those handy. Just for the sake of being able to jump and thread the needle with that that falling fireball. How's it going? Thank you very much for the good luck. I lost enough time here that we're going to be in the red, but I've got time to make up, so... It's a bummer, but what are you going to do? Ozia, how's it going? Up earlier, sorry for missing. Got a PB with commentary good enough to use for SGDP submission? Nice. Once I hit my goal. Okay. Or instead of losing 1 million years, hear me out here. Maybe I'm gonna only come 0.4 of a second off of gold. You know, that's another possibility, I suppose. I'm, a little bit confused. Tiny bit. It's not the number that I expected to see. Ooh, we're on pace. Once I hit my goal time, then I'm gonna start doing, SGDQ submission, attempts. Some commentary. Given, thank you for bringing the monster lair hype. Yeah, Cloudy, apparently that is a free hold. Yeah, half, definitely. That's a killer time. So on the off chance that anybody here isn't already following half coordinated, I'm kind of surprised, but also I'm here to tell you that you've made a mistake. And the nice thing about mistakes is that they're fixable. So fix the mistake. Slow boss fight. Probably lost like 3 seconds here. 4 seconds. Imagine a world where you lose 4 seconds against your gold in an auto-scroller. Anyone I can draft for couch backup? Well, Cyclone is going to be at SGDQ, and he's a real obvious candidate for that. I think Nyx might be at SGDQ, and if so, I definitely want him to be on my couch. I don't know how likely it is that the dev team would want to have a person on the couch since they've been patching out some of the tech. They might not be super into the idea, but I'm gonna reach out if it gets accepted to see if they want to be involved. they need to help me find the tech. I mean, it's one of those things where most of the time, like the speedrun strats that we're finding. Typically. Like, the devs aren't aware of it. You know, before it's found. Please go. Thank you. Way less health than I want to have right now. Drop a heart. Thank you. Almost happened again. Okay. Since this was already a bad run, I wanted to test out whether or not I could just cancel that menu and still go into the door. That's a bummer, but it's fine. So, Cloudy Shoe, you should talk to Half about his experience doing... did not want to go that way. Wanted to go down, not up. Those are opposites. Anyway, you should talk to Half about his experience with being a tester on Iconoclasts. That's not good. Alright, good to know that I have to do that. Still faster, but... it's no longer still faster. It is, just Fun fact, if we can get rid of the need for the ice sword in this room and the next room. Anyway, if we can get rid of the need for the ice sword in those two rooms, we can save, like, a lot of time. We can save a million years just by skipping the ice sword, because there's so much that's tied to doing it, to getting the ice sword. In a million years. Not really a different order, unfortunately. It's just, right now, progression is gated on having the ice sword. And if I could sequence break through one specific area, then I would be able to sequence break other things. I've already proved a bunch of sequence breaks. But because of the fact that we need the ice sword in those two specific spots, we still have to go back and get it, and going back to get the ice sword is extremely slow. So right now, in terms of time save, skipping just those two rooms is kind of the holy grail. Take another. And I think we're good. Nice. Yeah, Mazian. I actually don't know where this background music comes from. So I assume it comes from Monster World 3, since that's the only one that I haven't played. No, I don't need the form wheel at any spots, which is kind of a bummer because the form wheel glitch is really neat, but yeah, it's been routed out with better glitches. Yeah, tons of glitches. Nowhere near enough time to show them all off. It's funny, the form wheel glitch was only useful in one spot and it only saved about 3 seconds. And the new way of doing that area saves like 20. So it's not even one of those things where it's like, well, you know, depending on how good you are, one way's faster. No, it's just... turns out going into the menu's real slow. So when am I getting a Pepilogu tattoo? If I was gonna get a tattoo, that's probably the one that I would get, but tattoos aren't not super my thing. They look really good on other people. And I enjoy them, but how's it going? Yeah, Pepilogu is this little blue guy that's flying above me. Terrible first phase. I'm gonna first cycle it. No way. And I'm gonna potion in the next phase. What a bummer. Even. Awful. Just awful. Yo, Ellie, how's it going? setting up a system so that you can abuse piracy even more. Nice. Sad Gal, thank you very much for the good luck with what remains of the run. Nope, don't need you anymore. Need to go in the store. That's fine. We're playing for golds now, anyway. Time's dead. Yeah, Illy, I'm not surprised that that's the way you're going with it. But at some point, you're basically just re-implementing RTMP, right? Like, except over IRC, which is encapsulating your data in a way that probably isn't conducive to performance. Sine wave, how's it going? To be clear, I'm not telling you to stop. I'm telling you, at some point you have to recognize that you've re-implemented RTMP. Yeah, that song pattern never changes. Thanks. It's not where I wanted to be. Glad to hear that it's going well. This run. Is it dead enough for me to try something out? I think it might be. That one's gonna happen. Getting under that door would be huge. I would skip a lot of content. Okay. I'm going for the dump scrap. Risky. Thank you very much for the host. Welcome, everyone. I'm Tina Hax. I do a lot of speedruns. None of them very good, as I think I'm showing off right now. There we go. Thanks for the good luck. How did your runs go? Since you're still learning to run. What are you picking up? Hollow Knight. Oh, nice. But yeah, so anybody who doesn't already know Risky CB, we met when we were both doing glitch hunting in Iconoclasts. Which apparently is just going to be a recurring topic today. Super, super fun stream. And definitely worth your time. Okay, yeah, maybe I clipped through a wall a little bit. But also, the split that I'm about to have is going to be a red number. I think probably negates a little bit of any assertion that I'm good at video games. Red splits mean that you're going slow. Bread splits. If you want bread splits, you need to go to Scrumdiddlyumptious. Garbage. Yeah, new world record's dead. No biggie. That's fair, Ilyan. Yeah, right now my bad runs are about 30 minutes below second place. But they're still bad. That doesn't make them good, it just makes them slightly less slow than the next person. It's not the same thing as good. Good would be 1 hour and 54 minutes, which is, incidentally, probably 2 to 3 minutes faster than the time that I'm about to get. That's a fair point, and I want to make it real clear that when I talk about good or bad, that is only in relation to what I know I'm capable of. And that I am far more likely to cheer for somebody who gets a time that's way under my time. Than I am to cheer for a time of my own that I'm not happy with. Risky, you submitted Time Spinner for GDQ. I really hope that gets in. I played it casually and I fucking hated that game. I found it to be incredibly slow and just not fun to play. But watching, first watching Roguelink and then watching you do those runs, there's a really good speed game hiding inside of a game that otherwise feels like really, really slow to play. I maintain my criticism, though, that I think that the level design is substantially just way too horizontal. If you look at, like, Aria of Sorrow and, like, the good Igavanias, there's so little, like, horizontal corridors. And I get it. Like, Time Spinner wants to feel like there's, you know, distance being traveled, but figure out a better way, because the corridor rooms just, they're not fun. What prevents me from going through those moving blocks and not stopping? It's the lack of a dash. So if you look at the background, some of that background is covered and some of it isn't. The background that's not covered, there's a thing, I forget what it's called, but there's an enemy in the background that will drain your life. Okay. But yeah, you get your health drained really, really fast, like 2 seconds, and you potion. Yeah, the dash ends up being the only way that you can make it through without just dying, which is a bummer. mana potion. It's a bummer. But it's fine. God, I can't believe that we're on pace. Not potioning actually saves a fair amount of time. Oh, jeez. Yeah, we're actually on a pretty okay pace. Boss is gonna decide whether or not end this. There we go. Second try's not bad. Change forms, but it's fine. Alright, don't screw this up. No time lost there because I have to wait for this cycle anyway. Boss is going to decide whether or not this world records. So that's cool. Give me a good pattern. In all my bad runs, you've been giving me good patterns. Bottom right, let's go. Thank you. Now it's gonna be really embarrassing when I don't hit the world record. There's no way that you can speed up that. It just hits you 4 times. But you can feel productive. This boss fight's real fun. Especially with the speed strats. The speed strats make it really exciting. First phase, pretty okay. This is a phase, it's real scary. On the left, read out the shots to the right. Be on the right. Be on the left. Well, I guess we got my goal time, technically. Wow, 21 second goal. I don't even know how I did that. Stand by, Adelian. Bad run. Well, we're now 92 seconds away from sub 150 sum of best, so... that's real good. I'm gonna let the credits play out. I'm gonna do one more run. I'm gonna try something real dumb. Yeah, I'm gonna try something really, really stupid this upcoming run. Ariosh, thank you very much for the 70 Pride Bits. Just a reminder, since I've got a bunch of hosts tonight, thank you all, that all of my money, be it from cheers or from subs, all goes straight to the Extra Life charity drive that's linked in my stream info down below. So that makes me feel real good about what I'm doing, but hopefully you also feel real good about helping out sick kids. Yeah, I know. I'm real glad that I went and bopped that real bad world record that some jerk speedrunner had previously. Whoever that Tina Hax is, it's just a shitty run. You know, Illy, I've never tried to cheer from Chatty or WeChat. I've only ever cheered from the web client. Hack the game. I wish that I could. A remote debugger for the Switch would be really cool. I'd really, really, really like to have one. But alas, no such luck. Apparently Nintendo is cool about selling dev kits, but you gotta prove that it can be in a lockable room, etc. Yeah, but... like, my entire everything is based around open source. So... it probably wouldn't fly. VectorFan, thank you so much for the bits. Much appreciated. Caitlipsy, thank you as well. You're all too kind. I might do that, Illy. I might play a round or two of Tetris 99 as a palate cleanser before I do the next run. But yeah, so stupid idea, and if this works, it's pretty much a guaranteed world record, so I'll just say it right now. After I get the Snake Dash, I could... there's nothing stopping me from being able to get all the way to the Sphinx. So what I could do is get the Snake Dash, just go to the Sphinx, skip the boss fight, skip all that stuff, and then, because the Sphinx forces you into the frog shape, if that unlocks the frog shape, it could be pretty cool. Oh, but no. Yeah, not having the ice sword is doable. But part of the reason that it would be faster is because of the fact that you'd have frog. No, that might not actually be faster. It might be possible, but slow. I'm gonna be real. Possible but slow isn't... it's not something that I really like the thought of. Never mind. It's probably a bad idea. Wish it wasn't. Oh well. Three elixirs, 132. Not the worst. Gonna keep on pushing that down though.